Students, welcome to English class. Coming to the last part of the story, the mysterious picture. So in the last parts we saw Till, a painter appointed as the court painter of the Archduke of Battenberg. He was given a task that was to draw the portrait of the Archduke and the courtiers. But there was a difficulty that Till faced. We discussed that difficulty in the last class. Do you remember? Can you recollect it? Yes. What was that? All the courtiers wanted to make changes in their appearance while Till draw the picture. All of them wanted to make themselves attractive. They had certain problems with their appearance. They asked Till to rectify those problems and to draw very beautiful pictures. Otherwise, they threatened to kill him. At the same time, the Archduke asked Till to draw the picture without making any changes. Everyone should exactly look like as they are. There should not be even the slightest change. If there is any change, Till will be killed. So Till was in a very difficult situation. He understood that he cannot satisfy both the Archduke and the courtiers. Either he should satisfy the Archduke, then the courtiers will kill him. Otherwise, he should satisfy the courtiers, then the Archduke will kill him. So, however, it was not possible to draw the picture. But he asked the Archduke to show him the wall where he had to draw the picture. He asked three or four men to help him. He asked for thick curtains to protect his painting and all these things. That shows that he was drawing the picture. Okay, but we do not know what was his real plan. So, as he suggested, he was granted 30 days. On the 31st day, the Archduke came and inquired about the completion of the picture. Then what did Till say? It is not fully completed. He needed some more days. So the king allowed him to continue the picture and was granted 2 weeks time. And in the last part we saw that actually this Till was enjoying with his men by eating, drinking, etc. Nothing is mentioned about the painting. He was enjoying by feasting. That's the term that we have seen. Eating nice food, drinking wine, etc. So he was given 2 more weeks. So this is the next part we have to come to. So Till and his companions continued their merrymaking for another fortnight. What is fortnight? It refers to a period of 2 weeks, 15 days, a period of 2 weeks. So first 30 days, then 2 more weeks, that means 1.5 months. And here also what happened on the 45th day, the Archduke came there again and he asked the same thing. Isn't the picture completed? Isn't it time that the picture was completed? So what did Till say? Okay, it is almost completed. It is mentioned, Till said that the portrait was being given the finishing touches. The finishing touches, almost completed. Only the last few strokes. The rest is okay, completed. So he requested the Archduke for some more time. So The Archduke was ready to give him some more time. What he wanted was a perfect picture. And it was the last, time allotted. So he said that you should either complete the picture within 15 days or you should show me the unfinished picture now. So we know that 45 days already completed. So he was given 15 more days and he told that this will be the last time. He won't get any more time, but he was ready to grant him 2 more weeks to have a perfect picture. So then what happened? What happened? The same thing. What Till continued Till and his companions continued, enjoyed, it is mentioned again, Till and his companions enjoyed themselves for another fortnight. How did they enjoy? Feasting, eating nice food, drinking wine, etc. So 2 months completed. So at the end of this 2 months, what might have happened? Okay, the Archduke came there and asked. He didn't wait. What did he do? See, Archduke forced his way into the room and said, I must see the picture at once. Where is the picture? Draw those curtains apart. So was the picture ready? Okay, it says, the picture is ready, my lord, announced. He didn't tell any excuse this time that he needs some more time. He told that, okay, it is ready. So the king was, the Archduke was very anxious to see the picture, to see how he looked like, he looked in the portrait and all these things. But Till told that, okay, Archduke, okay, king, you please grant me one last favor. Okay, the picture is complete, but you should grant me last favor. What was that? See, please order all the courtiers to assemble in the this room. When they are here, I want to say a few words to them and then I will draw the curtain. That was the favor. He didn't ask for any more time because he knew that, okay, there was no need of that. Why? The picture was complete. So what was his last demand? Before showing the picture, all the courtiers should be there in the presence of the Archduke and all the courtiers Till will show the painting. Okay, so there was nothing wrong for that. So the Archduke was ready. So he asked all the courtiers to assemble in the hall. So while all of them reached there, Till addressed them. How? My lord, ladies and gentlemen, the picture is ready. You will now be able, as I draw the curtains, to see how well I have done my work. You can admire my work, but I must warn you that there is something very special about this picture. What did he say? Now I am going to show you this picture, but there is something very special about it. He gave them a warning. It was a special picture. What was that? See, only those among you who have noble blood in your veins will be able to see this painting. All of you cannot see it. Who can see? Only those people who are having noble blood in their veins will be able to see this painting. Otherwise, what will happen? If they are not having noble blood, all the rest, whatever their rank or position, maybe the king, the commander-in-chief, or the other important person of the palace, whatever their position, whatever their rank, what will they see? Will see nothing but a blank wall. So if they had to see the picture, what they needed was noble blood. All people cannot see. Only the people having noble blood can see. Otherwise, what will they see? They will see only a blank wall. So after telling this, he drew the curtains. And how many of the courtiers might have seen the painting? See, almost all, not all, almost all, I told you. Who didn't see that? You will see in the next part. Okay. The courtiers outdid one another in showing their admiration for the picture. What did the courtiers do? While still drew the curtains, they were surprised to see their picture. They were surprised. And what did each one of them do? Outdid one another in showing their admiration for the picture. How? Oh, look at my picture. It is very perfect. I haven't seen such a beautiful picture in my life. Nobody has drawn my picture so perfectly. So they were admiring till for his wonderful painting. Almost every one of them. So they praised Till for his splendid painting. We also know that Till was a very good painter because he was from Flanders. So they remarked how natural each one of them looked in the picture and eagerly pointed out their friends and acquaintances. They were competing in a sense to prove that they have a noble blood. They imagined that they saw their picture and they praised Till for his wonderful painting, and also they made comments about their friends and acquaintance. Okay. And only one person, who was that? All of a sudden, the Duke's jester leaped into the air and shouted. The court jester. Who is a jester? A person, a joker, we can say. A person who is appointed to make the king happy by his witty remarks and all these things. So only the jester shouted. What is that? All of you know that I am a fool and I have no blue blood in my veins. You know that what? I have no blue blood. I have no noble blood in my veins. I can see no picture but only a blank wall. I cannot see any picture. But what happened? All the other courtiers could see the picture. Only the court jester couldn't see the picture. He saw only a blank wall. And he admitted that he had no noble blood. What was the remark of Till? When fools begin to talk, observe Till, it is time for wise men to walk. It is meaningless to talk to foolish men. When fools begin to talk, it is time for wise men to walk. He calmly strode out of the hall and rode away on his donkey. What did he do? He moved outside. Till moved outside. After telling that, it is meaningless to talk to foolish men. So he went out of the palace on his donkey. The feathers in his cap danced in the gentle breeze. So that's the story. So students, we know actually what happened. This Till was a very cunning person, very intelligent person, and also talkative person. As he was in a very difficult situation, what was the difficult situation? To draw the picture of the Archduke and the courtiers. He knew that he cannot, however, draw the picture, death was sure. So he found out ways and means to save himself. And what was the means he thought in his mind? Not to draw the picture. But he cannot say that he cannot draw or he didn't draw. So very cunningly he told that only people with noble blood can see the painting and all the courtiers. In order to prove that they have noble blood, pretended. They didn't see, but they acted so. How? As if they had seen the picture. So this cunning and intelligent approach, behavior of Till saved him from death. So that's the story of the mysterious picture. So I think now you can understand why this story is titled the mysterious picture. What's the mystery? Now it is very clear to us. Okay, so children, that's end of the story. Now what you have to do is you have to complete the side questions and also the activities. And the next class, I will discuss some of the activities which you need explanation. Okay, so we will stop for today. Thank you. Make sure that you read the